Hello friends, good morning to everyone. So in my last class, I hope you understood parts of speech. In that last period, we finished two, noun and pronoun. So before going to continue, I will ask some questions regarding what you learned. Okay, so parts of speech means what? Parts of speech means what? When you speak, when you write, we use different type of words. Those are called what? Parts of speech. How many parts of speech are there? Yes. How many parts of speech are there? 8 parts of speech are there. Come on, tell me one by one. Noun, pronoun, adjective, verb, adverb, preposition, conjunction, and finally interjection. These are called what? Parts of speech. ಸೊ 8 ಪ್ರಕಾರಗಳು ಅದಾವು, ಅರ್ಥ ಆಯ್ತಾ? ಎಷ್ಟದಾವು? 8 ಇದ್ದಾವೆ. ಸೊ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಯು ಲರ್ನ್ಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನೌನ್. ನೌ ಯು ಟೆಲ್ ಮೀ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನೌನ್. ನೌನ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್? ನೌನ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ನೇಮಿಂಗ್ ವರ್ಡ್. ನೌನ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್? ಅ ನೇಮಿಂಗ್ ವರ್ಡ್. ನೇಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಪರ್ಸನ್, ಪ್ಲೇಸ್, ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್, ಬರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆನಿಮಲ್ಸ್. Totally, noun means naming word. So, kinds of noun. Which are the kinds of noun, tell me? Which are the kinds of noun you learnt? Proper noun, common noun, connecting noun, material noun, and abstract noun. You learnt. Already you learnt these are the things. Proper noun means what? Specific names, specific things. For example, Ganga, Ravi, those are called specific name. So common means what? Common, a boy, a girl, teacher, driver, those are a common noun. Now you tell me, collective noun means what? Group of people, person or things. Collective noun means what? Group of people, person or things. For example, crowd. Crowd, group of what? People. Army. Army, it is a group of soldier. Library is collection of what? Books. Is it understand? Family, group of people. Bunch, things, whatever take. Flock, group of animals. Okay, cattle, group of animals. Collective noun is what? Group of person, place or things, that is called a collective noun. So material noun is what? Things name, duster, chalk, pen, pencil, wood, stone. Those are material noun. So then abstract noun means tell me, abstract noun means what? Abstract noun means what? Those qualities we can't hold, we can't touch, we can't see. We can't see, we can't touch, we can't hold. Those are called abstract noun. For example, air. Air. Knowledge. See here. Air. Can you see? Can you touch? Can you hold? No. Only you feel. Air is blowing here. Knowledge. It is also invisible thing. It is also invisible thing. Then, intelligence. Intelligence, it is also invisible things. So only we can feel, only these bodies only we can feel, don't see, don't touch. Those are called abstract noun. Okay, so now you tell me what is pronoun. What is pronoun? Pronoun means what? It is used instead of noun. It is used instead of noun. What are the pronouns? Tell me. I, we, you, he, she, it, they. These are called what? Pronouns. Arthaita sarvanamagalu. ಇವಾಗ ನಾವೇನಂತ ಕೇಳ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂದರೆ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಕಾಲ್ ದೆಮ್ ಪ್ರನೌನ್ಸ್ ಸರ್ವನಾಮಗಳು ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ಸೊ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಸಿ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಅಡ್ಜೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್
ಅಡ್ಜೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ರೈಟ್ ಆನ್
ಥರ್ಡ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಅಡ್ಜೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಡ್ಜೆಕ್ಟಿವ್
ಇಟ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬ್ ಆರ್ ನೌನ್ ಆರ್ pronoun.
It describes a noun or pronoun, that is called an adjective. Okay,
for example, it is nice. It is nice. Nice, it is what? Adjective. It qualifies what? It describes it. It is what? Pronoun. Second example, write down. Rama is a tall boy. Rama is tall.
Rama is tall.
So otherwise you should have boy. Here Rama is a noun. Tall, it is an adjective word. It describes what? Tall word describes Rama. Here adjective describes noun here.
Okay.
Crow is dark. Crow is dark. Here crow it is what? Noun. Dark it is a what? Adjective. Okay. He is a brave boy. He is a brave boy. In this sentence, what is adjective word? Yes, brave, it is what? Adjective word. It describes what? He. He, it is what? Pronoun. Is it right? Let us see one more example. Sita is a good dancer.
Sita is a good dancer. In this sentence, what is adjective word?
Good.
Good, that is a adjective. Because this word describes what? Sita. Sita is a noun. Okay.
Tiger is a cruel animal. Yes, do you agree? Yes, tiger is cruel animal. Here, tiger is what? Noun. Cruel is an adjective.
Is it understand?
Ashok was a great king. Ashok was a great king.
In that sentence, which is adjective word?
Great. Then it describes Ashok. It is a noun. Then greater adjective. I am a good person. Yeah, good. It is what? Adjective. Or it is a
rose is beautiful. Here rose is a noun, beautiful adjective. Take one more example. The elephant is a big animal. Elephant is a big animal. Here, big is what? Adjective. Then, elephant is a noun. Did you understand? So, adjective means it describes a noun or pronoun. A noun or pronoun. Write down the example. Is it finished? Shall I continue? Let's go. Next one is a verb.
Next one is what? A verb. Next part of the speech is what? A verb.
Verb means what? Anybody idea? What is the meaning of verb?
It is an action word.
It is an action word. For example,
I speak truth. Raju walks every day. Yes, he sleeps at night. They run on the road. She writes a letter. Then Sita kills a rat. Then just put the numbers this like. Then seventh one. Teacher asked question.
Teacher asked a question.
Then we learn English. English grammar. We learn English grammar. Ninth one. Father reads newspaper.
Father reads newspaper.
I bring a car.
Okay. See here. Here in 10 examples are here. How many examples are here? Just to think. These are the sentences. What are the action word? What is action word in the sentence? First example is that I speak truth. Second example, Raju walks every day. Third example is that we sleep at night. Then fourth one, they run on the road. Fifth one, she writes a letter. Then sixth one, Sita kills a rat. Seventh one, teacher asks a question. Eighth one, we learn English grammar. Then ninth one, father reads newspaper. Last one is there, I bring a car. Can you find the action word? Can you identify what is action word? The first sentence, speak is what? Action word, speak. That's like walks is action word. Then sleep, run, rise, kills, ask, learn, reads, bring. Underline words. In these are the sentences, which are the underline words? Those are called what? Action word. Those are called what? Action words. Is it understand? Speak, walk, sleep, run, write, kills, ask, learn, reads, and bring. Those are called what? Action words. Okay. Write down an example. Is it finished? Shall I continue? Yes. What is the verb? Verb is an action word.
Just see the example. I am a teacher. It is a nice thing. So here in these are the sentences we did not use the main verb.
Here main verb is not necessary. Main verb is not necessary in this sentence. Why? I am teacher, it is correct. I am teacher, it is a correct sentence.
No need to write the main verb here. For example, I work as a teacher. I work as a teacher in this sentence. What is the main verb? Yes, work is a main verb.
There is necessity. I as a teacher, if you write that like, that is a wrong. I work as a teacher, that is a right. Okay, is it understand? Okay.
It works hard. It works hard. Thus, they are not necessary. It means here
helping verb is not necessary. In those are the sentences.
Here necessary. What? I am teaching. Here main verb not necessary. In there,
what? Main verb you should write. So it means what? How main verb is important as well as helping verb also very important. It's very very important. Okay. So let us see what are the helping verbs?
Helping verbs. Write down the helping verbs. Do, does, then, am, is, are, here you should write better, then, was, where, then, Now has had will shall.
Understand? Helping verbs are here. See, do, does, did. Am, is, are. Was, where. Have, has, had. Will, shall. These are called what? Helping verbs.
Let's say auxiliary also there. Auxiliary verbs are there. Let's see what are the auxiliary verbs. Should, could, could. No, so can, past tense, could. Can it is a present tense.
Okay.
Must. These are called what?
Auxiliary verbs. Okay. Write down. Helping verbs and auxiliary verbs. So one more thing you have to study in verb. One more thing you have to study in verb. Let us see what is that.
Regular verbs, regular verbs and irregular verbs. What is the difference between
regular and irregular verbs?
Regular and irregular verbs. So V1, V2, then V3. Tell me what is that?
V1 means present tense, V2 means past tense, V3 means past participle. Is it understand? V1 means what? Verb 1, it means present tense. V2, that is a past tense. V3 means a past participle, that is called a V3. Let us see what is regular verbs and what is irregular verbs. Regular verbs, it has a systematic or particular pattern. You see here, listen carefully. Regular verbs have a particular pattern. Regular verbs have a particular pattern. How? See here.
For example, pull. What is the V2 of pull?
Because pull it is V1.
What is the V2 of pull? Pulled. Then V3,
what is that?
You are also pulled. Then ask. What is the V2 of ask? Asked. Here, ask. Wash. Here what? Washed. Here, wash. Then,
tell me.
Jump. Here, what you write? Jump. Here, jump. Here, what's the time?
V2 and V3 and V3. V2 and V3 and with what? ED. So that is called a regular verb. Regular verb means a pull, pulled, pulled. Just you have only ED in V2 and V3. You should add only
ED and also ED.
That is called a regular verb. Irregular means
For example, let us see what is the difference between regular and irregular. For example, go. What is the root of go? Went. Then we drink born.
Go, went, gone. Is it understand? It is totally different. Not like the regular verbs. These are not like the regular verbs. Totally different. The present, past and past participle totally different.
Then write. Then wrote. Here what you write? Return.
Okay.
Buy. Bought. Here bought. Bring. Brought. Here also brought.
Do you know the difference between regular and irregular verbs? Okay. Just you should learn this one. Regular. If anyone asks you what is regular verb, what is irregular verb, you ready to answer. You ready to answer. Is it understand? Let us take the homework regarding what you learned now in the class.
Homework, write down 10 examples of adjectives. Write 10 examples of adjective. That is the first homework. Then write 25 verb forms.
Write 25 verb forms. You have to write 25 verb forms. That's like V1, V2, V3. That's like you make separate column. In that column, you should write V1, V2 and V3. Is it understand? Do you do the homework? Yes. So next class, we will discuss about adverb, then preposition, conjunction and interjection. Those are remaining in parts of speech. In the next class, we will discuss another one, parts of speech. Okay. Bye.